Arsenal draw with Southampton. Let me tell you why the title race is over and why that's good for us. We'll look at what Arsenal fans, blogs and tweets alike, are saying on social media. And obviously, across the internet. And if my voice sounds croaky, it's because it's not too long ago that I rolled out of bed. I hope you can hear me clearly. But yeah, let's get on to the podcast. You know we like to keep it short and sweet, so you can go about your business. This draw with Southampton. Am I livid? Yes. Very.
What is he doing? Why, Nunu? Why? Why?
But I'll keep this podcast short and sweet, and I'll try to be as objective as I can while doing it. This leaking defense we have, I'm not quite sure why all of a sudden, when Saliba, or just about the time Saliba got injured, we just started to concede more goals. And here I am not trying to put the blame on anybody, but I'm thinking that if the defense becomes categorically weak because of the absence of one defender, I would assume that the entire team would be defending as a unit in this situation, in this sort of situation. But I'm not quite sure what's going on. We've been leaking goals. We've been going on the back foot really more often than we should. So I think, no, not I think, Arteta should look at how we can mitigate this defensive leakages while we have one of our best defenders out. Let's start defending as a unit. You know how he did it in that time when we had Kolasinac and Aubameyang? That very first time he took over, we were defending as a unit as opposed to just relying on the defenders, because our defense or the defenders we had weren't that much quality. So I think we should be reverting back to that. I don't know if that's what he's doing, but it didn't seem to me like that was the plan, you know. And we don't have the level of quality that we should be having with Saliba out of the team at the moment. So I'm not just talking about the back line, I'm talking about everybody. Now this is the third time this is happening where we're drawing, and this is the second time that we are drawing games that we should have been winning. And the boys seem afraid, unsure and distracted. It might be the pressure of this title challenge, which, by the way, I think is off the books now. And yes, I know it's a young team, but that's why we have more experienced players in the team. Whether it's in age or whether it's in title winning experiences. People like Zinchenko and Jorginho. Is that how to pronounce his name? But you know what I mean. Zinchenko, Holding and Vieira, not quite sure what happened to their game, but that performance needs to be improved and quickly. We're not playing with the bite we used to, you know, where we would just be really ruthless the first 15, 20, 30 minutes of the game. It's almost like we're stuttering, like a car that's about to start, you know, and you have the exhaust just sputtering smoke. We're yet to go back to how we were playing at the start, you know. How many times did I say, you know? I say that a lot, I'm not sure why. But moving on, our opponents have stopped being afraid. West Ham and now relegation-bound Southampton. Our opponents have stopped being afraid. Even more so, they stopped being afraid of coming to the Emirates. And we need to rectify that.
This is Sparta!
Our next four games will be the hardest. We have City, we have Chelsea, we have Castle, we have Brighton. These are not easy games. Now, is our title race over? I'd hate to call us bottlers, really, I'd hate that. But somehow we're living up to the billing. I'm not going to throw tantrums just because at the start of the season, the title was never really on the cards. Fourth place? Yes, please. Third place? Amazing. Title? What is that? You know, so title was never on the cards at the start of the season, so that's why if I was maybe a City fan or a Liverpool fan, then I have, you know, rights to throw tantrums, but I'll be happy with second. So let's just secure that second place. So I'm not going to lose much sleep. At least I'll try not to. But we need to figure out a way to be scary again. We need to figure out a way to let people know that we are the Arsenal, not be taking the piss and letting goals in 27 seconds into the play. What's that?
How dare you?
You know, please, boys. But considering the current defensive issues we have, I'm shuddering at the thought of playing City. I'm shuddering at the thought of playing Newcastle and Brighton, because these are good teams. These teams will punish you, and punish you so bad, the scars will remain for reminder's sake. You would remember.
It's time for the punishment.
You know. And yeah, there's Chelsea. And even though they're a mess now, but so are Southampton and West Ham and whoever else, but see what's happened. So that's why I'm not brushing over Chelsea, because relegation bound teams like Southampton and West Ham have come and made life difficult. So yes, Chelsea could give us problems. Or I may be wrong. Maybe our title race isn't over. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Now on Twitter, I think all you need to do is search Arsenal on Twitter and you'd feel the pulse of the nation. Sorry, fans. Enough said about that. The best tweet I've seen though was from Gunners Blog, which also featured an article, or was featured in an article on The Athletic. Gunners Blog says, I've been saying it for a while, but including FA Cup, Arsenal will face Manchester City 3 times this season. You can't lose everyone and claim to be the best team in the country. If you want to complete the game, you've got to beat the final boss. Wednesday is gigantic, and rightly so. City are the team to beat. Yes, a couple of giant killers made life difficult for them in the course of the season. But if we can beat City, that might give us a glimmer of hope. That seems like a David and Goliath thing right now, considering that our boys seem unsure and scared and, you know, not quite sure what it is that's going on with them mentally. But that's why I'm asking, you know, what you think if our title race is over. Because I don't want us to just accept defeat right now. If we can win City and win every other game that we play, then we could still win the title. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Now, if you also want to read the interview or the article on The Athletic about Arteta and how he is still swooning over the team, irrespective of the draw, because of the way that we came back, I'll leave the link in the description below. Also, you can pick up the latest collection of Stone Island on Aphrodite 1994. The affiliate link is in the description and purchasing will be at no extra cost to you. Note of warning though, the things are really good quality, but can be a little pricey. It's like an understated Mr. Porter Aphrodite or Aphrodite 1994. They've got high quality stuff. Not as expensive as Mr. Porter, but still not, you know, everyday prices. Just so, note of warning, but you like what you get. We've also got links in the description for Arsenal stadium tours and ticket exchanges. So we have approval to advertise Arsenal products. So Arsenal kits, Arsenal stadium tours. And also, if you want to go to the game for Chelsea, the Chelsea game, I don't think there are tickets left for the Manchester City game. But if you want to attend the Chelsea game, and I think the Brighton game, you'd have to register, I think. I'll have a look and then give proper explanation in the description. But yeah, the links to tickets If you want to purchase tickets, if you want to purchase kits, where there's the first, second, or third kit, and if you want to go on an Arsenal Stadium tour of the Emirates, the links are in the description below. They will come at no extra cost to you, but using them really helps support the channel and support the podcast. Have a great day, Gunners. God bless.